somebody's hiring a personal injury lawyer, I think they want to look at what their past track record has been, what type of successes have they had in the past, what type of cases have they handled in the past. This lawyer that you're interviewing, have they had experience in the type of matter that you're looking at, whether it's medical malpractice, product liability, aviation? Have they had? Do they have a trial record? There are a number of lawyers who represent that they have experience in personal injury who do not have a trial background. In fact, what they wind up doing is doing a disservice to the client a number of times because they don't have that trial experience. The most difficult thing for a personal injury trial lawyer is to be able to convince a juror, somebody who has no experience, no relationship to your client, what your client is going through, what they're experiencing. In order to be able to communicate that to a jury, you have to be able to feel it yourself. You have to be able to place yourself in the shoes of your client, know what they're going through, and in order to communicate that to a jury. So compassion is, frankly, the whole reason that you go into this business. The most rewarding part of our job is when a case is over and we're able to sit down and offer the client a couple of different things. Sometimes it's just their day in court. They need to have their story told. They need to be able to get their experience off of their chest. They need to be able to go through the psychological value of having a trial. Sometimes that's more important than the financial compensation that they derive. But at the end of the case, and I don't think it's ever happened, where a client has not said, I did not realize how hard you worked on my file, I didn't realize the preparation that was involved in your case, and thank you for giving me back my dignity, and thank you for putting our family in a position of security. And that's what's rewarding about our practice. Our office uses a contingency fee because most of our clients cannot afford to hire us on an hourly basis. And a contingency fee allows a client to hire our law firm to work on their behalf. And what we do is we take a third of the recovery, if there is a recovery. If there is no recovery, then they are not responsible for any of our fee. And the reason we do that is it allows us to level the playing field. A contingency fee allows us, a relatively small law firm, but one that is very focused because this is the only type of work that we do, to represent our clients. And we make a deal with our clients. If we don't win your case, if we don't bring you a successful result, then you're not responsible for our fee. And it's worked well for us, and I think that's what allows our country to have access to justice.